Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. What you should know about bending stress. First thing you have to know is the second moment of area of selected cross sections. Ini adalah contoh cross section 40 cm by 80 cm. Contoh cross section is this one. This is 40, ini 80 cm. And dia ada panjang dia. Okay. So the second moment of area is calculated by the formula BD cube divided by 12, di mana B merupakan jarak yang selari dengan paksi neutral. This is paksi neutral ni. So B is 40 and D is 80. Andai kata daya dikenakan horizontal, so the paksi neutral will be vertical. So dia punya B will be this one, D is this one. Okay. Kalau dia berbentuk macam ni, di mana center of rectangle is centrally placed. So basically yang dalam ni, rongga dalam ni, dia punya paksi neutral pun tengah-tengah. Rongga luar paksi neutral pun di tengah-tengah. Maka keseluruhan paksi neutral adalah tengah-tengah. So kita boleh buat guna formula I keluar tolak I dalam. Itu I of the cross section, di mana I luar adalah BD cube, 40, 80 cube divided by 12, minus 24, 60 cube divided by 12. Okay. Now, suppose we have this example, di mana kita ada dua macam I beam ni, di mana rongga tengah-tengah, kita boleh pecahkan kepada tiga. Satu, dua dan rongga tiga. So, supposedly this rongga is centrally placed. Kiri kanan sama dan bawah 4 mm daripada bawah. Now, how do we define this cross section second moment of area? First, you define the reference point and then identify the main elements. Elements 1, 2 and 3. 3 is the rongga. Okay, and then identify the center of each elements of reference, meaning to say that for element 1, the center from the bottom will be 30 campur dengan center of 30 ni 15. The Y1 ni 45. Y2 will be 4 campur dengan this is 7. So 21. Dan Y3 will be half of 30, all from the reference. So kita ada Y1 ialah 45, Y2 ialah 15 dan Y3 ialah 11. And then kita use the first moment area to determine the Y bar, which means A1 multiplied by Y1 is A2 multiplied by 2 and minus A3 multiplied. The minus sign because it is rongga ni. So it's minus. So equal to A1 plus A2 minus A3 Y bar. So Y bar is equal to this equation. Dan masukkan nilai yang dia, di mana I untuk bulat ialah pi d 4 over 64. Ini area. Di mana area is pi d square over 4. Okay. Y bar is equal to 23.19. Okay. Next, we have to define what is H1, H2, H3. H1 is distance from centroid here to the paksi neutral, and Y2 merupakan centroid. Y2 is merupakan distance from the center here of the T to the centroid, the paksi neutral, and Y3 merupakan distance from the centroid to the center of the circle. So setiap centroid itu kita bezakan dengan paksi neutral keseluruhannya. So H1 is the Y1 minus Y bar, where H1 itu is Y bar minus Y2 itu H2, dan Y bar minus Y3 itu H3. So we get, this is the result we get. Okay, now having said that, we can find I is equal to I1 campur A1 squared plus I2 to H2 squared minus, because it's a rongga, I3 campur A3 H2 squared. So knowing that I is equal to pi d 4 over 64 untuk bulatan, so we get 343.97. Okay, now if you have a beam, The bending moment of the beam will be like this. This is the bending moment diagram. Guna persamaan dari chain moment tu. And so on and so forth. Okay. Now, kalau kita tengok this positive, it is here compression atas, tension di bawah. Meaning to say that below the neutral axis is tension, above the neutral axis is compression. So atas sini is compression, bawah adalah tension. So kalau kita guna stress kita MY over I, M is 9 kilometer, Y refers distance from neutral axis, and I refers to the second move area. And if you are thinking about tensile, since tensile is bawah, so Y is bottom maximum. Bottom maximum will be the Y bar from the neutral axis. Okay, this is the answer. For maximum compressive pula, since the top is compression, so the Y will be from here to atas sekali. Okay, which is 60 tolak Y bar. Okay, so this dia punya result dia 60 tolak Y bar. So stress maximum. Thanks for watching.